Welcome to TradeTheNBA.com. This is John's report. It's for January the 4th, and well, you're looking at it right there. Red dot short shows up on the market. Interesting timing after this nice power up move immediately off of our catfish signals that we had right here. Did we get overbought? You know, we went positive 10 previous day. Today, only plus 8. So, yeah, we have lower positive extreme. This lower close would have liked to have seen a higher finish on the day. It was up a little bit, but you know, we had been talking about this just the other day where we were looking for MACD buyers to kind of fill in as, you know, earlier traders that, you know, expected the move start selling into them. And so they used that extra liquidity to exit the scenario. And, you know, when we look at the numbers, the relationship here, we can always just do the math right now. We'll just do it together. So we have 1692 into 3048 on the up down power. That's only about 55%, so that's not horrible. But if we look at the SPY, it's a little bit different compared to the cash indexes. Support and resistance lines, we hit that 1465. Remember, we still had upside target maximum from a weekly all the way up to 1474. So not forgetting about that. Got back inside the Bollinger Bands for technical, you know, purposes. Guys like to see that. But you can see the relationship here a little bit higher from an SPY standpoint. If you take that 238 and divide it by the 364, you get into the mid-60s. And that gets us very close to that 70 threshold, which would clearly be a short overall. So the fact that we just changed from red to green trend, that causes a little bit of a caveat because you know that we're likely to see a day or two decline going from red to green trend before you resume to the upside. So we're going to need to see a little bit more weakness in the setup before we really attack a short setup here. From a price oscillator standpoint, we know that back here when we entered 2020, we were looking for a nice move, and sure enough, we got it. You got MACD buyers that just got their buy signal after the move is already done. And, you know, too many times I'm telling us to sell into them. You know, as far as our SSO setup, so we had our leftover from the previous year, and then I put up the ABM to follow us for a stop, 59.50, a little bit too far back. I actually adjusted that, so I think I have to refresh this real quick. Let's do that. There we go, 62 and a quarter is where I put the stop, and that was based off of the ABM right here. It kind of came up, if you were had it with the indicators, you would have already stopped yourself out way up here in the 63 plus range. And you can see that we had the lower histogram on the shakeout right here. So lower histogram, higher price, that divergence is always negative. Let me see it more and more, but you know, already oversold just on this little dip. So it's interesting to see when you get oversold that fast. And we kind of looked at that the other day when we saw that we were expecting a little bit of a retrace. We did get some of that retrace, and then it just moved right back up. USO, we're looking for a little more of a pullback before we would go ahead and sell new puts into there. Shakeouts above the warning line. So yeah, we should be able to see somewhat of a pullback, particularly if we get more action from that short cigarette signal. And that should give us a little bit of an advanced warning on when to get more active about like selling puts for next week type setup. Gold pulled back a little, retrace actually puts in a gray dot along with that same retrace on there. So not too shocking overall with that. It's had a nice build back up. This would be very attractive very shortly here on the next improvement with the shakeup that for a long play on gold, because you can see that that extreme histogram is going to be much higher than it was back over here with price at the same point. So another divergence to the upside for that. And that wouldn't be too shocking because you might see people move more into gold if the market pulls back. CLF from our standpoint, now we had sold. Let's go and put CLF return back here. We just click the stock every time. Takes us right to it. So we sold 37 calls on CLF, got about 60 cents. So we're capped in at about 37.60 on our 300 shares that we have right there. And we had the nice, huge move up. Well, it started to come back. We have a potential on Friday that we may actually be right about break-even. If we get to the even spot, we're still going to sell the share, let the shares get called away. The whole point of it was to finish out a trade from last year. And we'll go ahead and sell new puts on the proper setup. You know, this first developing lower shakeout, we want a little bit more. I'd love to see it come back down around in this mid-35 range at a point where the market's at least retraced and done its thing as well. Packs from our standpoint looking fine. We have a couple other shares of packs. Let's go take a look at that setup right here. So you'll see that Monday, after I've had a chance over the weekend to reset everything, the cost basis will get adjusted to what the close was at the beginning of the year, and then any improvement from there will be adjusted. You'll note that the stop 2440 overall, it's at 2542. We were expecting a little bit of a pullback from the positive extreme, and now you have a lower one, lower positive. Even though it's lower close, you still would look for retrace down to at least that 2485 level. And it was nice, still off the bullish orange dot, nice pop. Everything worked out pretty well as far as the indicators. I mean, they called beautifully WLT into the fiscal cliff buying. I mean, you know, some people told me I was nuts having everyone buying and selling puts into the fiscal cliff, particularly for something like WLT. But, you know, they lined up early and added through the setup and then just boom, took off. So, gray dot looked for a little retrace of the low, so no issue with where we're at with WLT. And we had a strong position on it, full 600 shares. I wanted us to sell half of that at 37. So fine, we're clear on that. And we'll probably be looking if we get any improvement here to sell next week's calls on it. So we'll take a look at that. We have the higher close there, but we'll at least reflect what we had from that positive move. So that was an excellent trade. Let's get back to that real quick. 33.76 was our cost basis. So from 33 to 37 in less than a week. Yeah, that's not bad at all. So here we are looking at the ES from a daily standpoint. Now, we don't have the same red dot that you saw on the cash index. All right, so still a little bit of a variation between our cash index and the futures. And what's even more interesting, if we flip over here, we go to the MBI Opus, and it actually puts in a buy signal for that green GAM. So that's very interesting to see that set up, particularly at the point where from daily ES futures, we see more shorts adding into the setup. So we're just going to hold for another day, and we'll see how this evens out, whether or not we get a clear short signal both from the ES as well as from the cash index, the INX, and then we can make a trade accordingly. But overall, we're in fine shape, not doing anything wrong, and the portfolio is going to be ready to really blossom, and we'll attack it early. So, as always, continue to look for me, though, on StockTwits and Live feeds that I've been doing. And I also, just to let you know, added those future setups that I showed the other day on our website. Let me just go ahead and direct you to it real quick so that you can get an idea. If we go back here, we'll just go to the homepage and MBI Opus Strategies and the performance. And I put them all the way down here. So thanks to Andre for giving us those updates, and just put them all down in here so you can fill in the settings if you want to create the exact same trade. And I showed how that worked on actually live broadcast that I did, and that actually should be up on YouTube for anyone who missed it, or you can just go to the live channel at livestream.com/TradeTheMBI. So there you have it, a quick one, but please stay in touch because we may have some new trades to make depending on what the signals give us for Friday. As always, trade well.